Hello, today we are going to learn about document sets within ABBYY FlexiCapture. Now, some way that we look at document sets is it's actually easier just to see it as a finished product before we dive into the creation of such a thing. So, as you can see here, I have a batch and I have a mortgage document set, and within my document set, I have multiple separate documents. Now, the concept of a document set is that we can have a package or a set of documents that flow together throughout the software, throughout workflow, and throughout the export process. And that's critical that they stay together. And this is very common in mortgage processing, loan processing, but typically any situation where, as a business, we want documents to stay as a group together. And this is how the software displays it to us. So we have a document set and we have additional documents that belong to the set. If I double click the top level, I will see what we call a summary tab, which is optional, but in this demo today, we do have a summary tab. And then, of course, I have the subsequent documents that flow around. I can double click them and open them up independently, or I can use the summary tab and double click them and open them up directly from the summary tab. I'm a big fan of this because I like the ability that if I double click anywhere on the summary tab in a field, the software will not just only open the given document, but will open the document with the field that I selected or double clicked on. So the summary tab gives us a lot of capabilities. Also, just like any other part of FlexiCapture, if we want to perform comparisons or if we want to create rules at the summary level, we can do that as well. So once again, document sets allow the software to maintain a group of documents as it flows through workflow. Now, what I'm going to do is actually show you how we go throughout the process of creating a mortgage document set. Before I do so, I want you to understand that when we create a document set, we're showing fields from a group of documents, of course. And in order for a field to be accessible to us, we must create fields as index fields. So in order for a field to be listed as an index field, we just need to go into the given document definition. And I'll show you here real quick. And just double click the field and make sure that that field is an index field here. Okay. Once we do that at the document definition level, we can reference that at a document set level. So let's do that now. Let's create our mortgage document set. What I'm going to do is I'm going to hit new. I'm going to go to document set. I'm going to add a summary. This is optional, but for today's demo, we will. We select the different documents that we want associated with the document set. And we create our document set with a given name. At this point, our document definition editor opens, and on the right, we see our document structure. So the software is going to provide us a summary tab because that's what we selected. And we will also have reference to additional fields here from the subsequent documents that we've created. Now, if I go to testing and run test, the software will show me what that summary tab would look like, which is pretty neat because we may decide to show or reorder things to an end user. And we also have the ability to link additional fields that we're maybe not going to display. So if I wanted to link or show an existing field on the summary tab, I can do that by right-clicking on the summary and selecting the proper field that I want to display here as well. So another way that we can do that and make it very easy for an end user to see all of the fields at one time. Lastly, I will mention that a document set, once again, is just a combination of separate documents. And just like any other assembly situation that we have throughout FlexiCapture, we have that same option at a document set level. So it's very important to understand that you may want to tweak the assembly options that you have here. We may have some sections that are optional, and hence they have an option of having a minimum of zero, or they may be always required in a given document set or package. So important for you to understand that the assembly rules that happen throughout traditional FlexiCapture processing also happen at a document set level as well. And lastly, I'll just kind of mention to you that just like traditional FlexiCapture, we have the ability to create rules, compare fields, perform math, do database lookups. And once again, every field will have the ability for us to create rules here. Just by double-clicking on the specific document section, I can create rules and do all kinds of neat stuff that we do in traditional FlexiCapture as well, but do that for a whole document set. Okay, so once we're done creating a document set, we'll publish to our document definition. And once we start processing documents, they will show up accordingly, where we will have a high-level option here which is the document set, and then each independent document will show up there as well under that document set. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, would you do me a favor and click the like button, the subscribe button, and even click that notification bell so that you can be notified when we post new videos. Thank you.